हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द थर्ड वीडियो ऑफ पार्शियल फ्रैक्शंस। सो आफ्टर रिवीजन ऑफ फ्रैक्शन एंड पॉलीनोमियल्स, इन टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट पार्शियल फ्रैक्शंस। नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ पार्शियल फ्रैक्शंस? सो इन मैथमेटिक्स वी कैन सी मैनी कॉम्प्लेक्स रैशनल एक्सप्रेशंस। इफ वी ट्राई टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम्स इन द कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्म, इट विल टेक अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम टू फाइंड द सोल्यूशन। नाउ टू अवॉइड दिस कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी, वी हैव टू कंटिन्यू द प्रॉब्लम बाई रिड्यूसिंग द कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्म ऑफ द रैशनल एक्सप्रेशन इन टू द सिंपलर फॉर्म। Partial fraction decomposition is one of the method which is used to decompose the rational expressions into simpler partial fractions. Okay, so this means that what we are doing, we are reducing the fraction in addition or subtraction form. Okay, so simple example, class, we all know that 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 3. Right? In school, you have given 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 3 and the question is add these two fractions, right? 1 upon 2 is a fraction, 1 upon 3 is a fraction and the question is add 1 upon 2 and 1 upon 3. So, how to add this? We have, what we are doing? We are just cross multiplying these terms. So, 1 into 3 plus 1 into 2 upon 2 into 3, right? So that is equal to 3 plus 2 upon 6, so that is equal to 5 upon 6, right? So addition of 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 3, addition of fractions 1 upon 2 and 1 upon 3 is 5 upon 6, right? So partial fraction is, you know that 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 3 is equal to 5 upon 6, right? So partial fraction is 5 upon 6 is given. Okay, what is given? 5 upon 6 is given and we have to find these two terms. Means we have to write this 5 upon 6 as 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 3. Okay, this 1 upon 2 and 1 upon 3 is known as a partial fractions of 5 upon 6. Okay, understood? This 1 upon 2 and 1 upon 3 is known as a partial fractions of 5 upon 6. Means here 5 upon 6 is given. Okay, in school we are given 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 3. Right, and we have to find 5 upon 6, right? Now 5 upon 6 is given and we have to find these two terms. Okay, we have to find the fractions of 5 upon 6. That means writing this 5 upon 6 as addition or subtraction form. Clear? So this 1 upon 2 and 1 upon 3, 1 upon 2 and 1 upon 3, these two terms are known as the partial fractions of 5 upon 6. Okay? So this is the meaning of partial fraction. Okay? So partial fraction definition. An algebraic fraction can be broken down into simpler parts known as partial fraction. Okay, so this 2 upon x minus 3 minus 1 upon 2x plus 1, this is a partial fractions. Okay, this is a single term 3x plus 5 upon 2x square minus 5x minus 3. So this 3x plus 5 upon 2x square minus 5x minus 3, right? This can be written as 2 upon x minus 3 minus 1 upon 2x plus 1, right? So this term is known as a partial fractions of this term. Okay, so partial fractions of 3x plus 5 upon 2x minus 5x minus 3 is 2 upon x minus 3 minus 1 upon 2x plus 1. Okay, so that means splitting the polynomial fraction into sum or difference form. Okay, either in sum form or a difference form is known as a partial fractions. Okay, so partial fractions means dividing these terms, okay, finding the factors of this part, factors of denominator, and separating the factors of denominator is known as a partial fractions. Okay, so finding the partial fraction of proper fractions. Now let's see the steps how to find the partial fractions of a proper fraction. So very first thing, class, just make a note, we can find partial fractions only for proper fraction. Okay, only for proper fraction. Partial fraction is only for proper fraction. We cannot find partial fractions of improper fractions. Okay, so to find the partial fraction, there is a condition. What is the condition? Condition is fraction should be a proper fraction. If the fraction is not a proper fraction, we cannot find the partial fractions. So first step is check whether the given fraction is proper or improper. Okay, first step is checking whether the given fraction is proper fraction or improper. If it is improper, then what we have to do? We have to convert it into a proper fraction. So after converting into proper fraction, then only we can find the partial fractions. Okay, otherwise we cannot find the partial fractions. Okay, so step one is, first step is check whether the given fraction is proper or improper. If it is improper, then convert into proper. Okay, second step is factorize the denominator completely. Okay, find all the factors of a denominator. Find denominator completely, then factors of denominator can be of the following form. Okay, so first step is check whether the given fraction is proper or improper. Second step is factorize the denominator. After factorizing denominator, we have to check this. Now, on the basis of factors of denominator, okay, if the denominator is having linear and different factors, okay, see the case one, see the denominator. Denominator having linear, right? Linear means power of x is 1, right? So in denominator, see ax plus b and cx plus d. These are the factors, right? A and b, c and d are constant values. Variable is x, right? And power of x is 1. So denominator is having linear and different function, okay, different factors. So if the denominator is having linear and different factors, then partial fraction can be written as a upon ax plus b plus b upon cx plus d. Okay, so case one, when the denominator has linear factors and non-repeated factors, okay, linear and different factors, then partial fractions can be written as a upon ax plus b upon cx plus d, where capital A, capital B are constants. Okay, once again, case one, okay, step one is check whether the given fraction is proper or improper. After checking proper or improper, if it is improper, then convert into proper, and if it is proper, then go to the second step. Second step is factorize the denominator completely. Okay, on the basis of factors of denominator, we can find the partial fractions, right? So if the denominator is having linear and different factors, if the denominator is having linear and different factors, then partial fractions will be a upon first factor plus b upon second factor. Okay, now second case, in case 2, denominator having linear but repeated factors. Okay, so if the denominator is having linear but repeated factors, see, factor of denominator is ax plus b whole square, right? Whole square means this ax plus b is repeated twice, right? Like 2 raised to 2 is equal to 2 into 2, right? Similarly, ax plus b whole square means ax plus b into ax plus b. So this ax plus b is repeated twice. Okay, so in second case, partial fraction will be a upon ax plus b plus b upon ax plus b whole square. Okay, factor is single but it is repeated twice, so we also have to repeat it twice in partial fractions. Okay, so first a upon ax plus b one time, then plus b upon ax plus b whole square. Okay, see, there is one more case. See the this one, what is given here? One factor is ax plus b, right? Denominator is having one factor as ax plus b, and the other factor of denominator is cx plus d whole square. Now this cx plus d whole square is repeated twice, right? This is a linear. Even cx plus d is also a linear, but this cx plus d is repeated twice. This ax plus b is non-repeated factor, but this cx plus d is repeated factor. So for this, partial fraction will be a upon ax plus b, right? Now this ax plus b is non-repeated, so single term, right? Single term. So a upon ax plus b plus b upon cx plus d. This cx plus d is repeated twice, na? So cx plus d, and again we have to write c upon cx plus d whole square, right? This case is a combination of first two case. Here denominator has two factors. One is non-repeated linear factor and the other one is repeated linear factor. Okay, a for non-repeated linear factor we have to write a upon ax plus b. For repeated linear factor we have to follow the this one, right? This one procedure. So once again, a upon ax plus b. Why? Because ax plus b is a linear non-repeated factor. Then b upon cx plus d, but this cx plus d is repeated factor, right? Square hai. So this is repeated twice, so again I have to write c upon cx plus d whole square. Clear? So first case is linear factor, where the factors are linear and non-repeated, both the factors are different. In second case, repeated linear factors. So if it is repeated twice, then we have to write two terms. If it is repeated thrice, then we have to write three terms. Okay, for example, suppose if it is 1 upon ax plus b raised to 3, so that will be a upon ax plus b plus b upon ax plus b whole square प्लस सी अपॉन ए एक्स प्लस बी होल क्यूब. ओके, सो दिस टर्म इज रिपीटेड थ्राइस, सो वी हैव टू राइट दिस टर्म एज थ्री टाइम्स इन पार्शियल फ्रैक्शंस. क्लियर? नाउ थर्ड केस. इन थर्ड केस वन टर्म इज लीनियर एंड द अदर टर्म इज क्वाड्रेटिक, राइट? दिस ए एक्स प्लस बी इज अ लीनियर फैक्टर एंड सेकेंड फैक्टर इज एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस सी स्क्वायर, वेयर सी इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट, राइट? सो एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस सी स्क्वायर इज अ क्वाड्रेटिक. वाई क्वाड्रेटिक? बिकॉज योर वेरिएबल इज एक्स एंड पावर ऑफ एक्स इज स्क्वायर, राइट? सो एक्स इज रिपीटेड ट्वाइस, राइट? एक्सपोनेंट ऑफ एक्स इज टू. सो सिंस द डिग्री ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल इज टू, सो दिस इक्वेशन इज नोन एज अ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. सो क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन, राइट? फॉर दिस, फॉर लीनियर नॉन रिपीटेड फैक्टर, पार्शियल फ्रैक्शन विल बी ए अपॉन ए एक्स प्लस बी. ओके, एंड फॉर क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन पार्शियल फ्रैक्शन विल बी बी एक्स प्लस सी. ओके, लीनियर अपॉन क्वाड्रेटिक. सो वेन एवर डिनोमिनेटर हैज अ क्वाड्रेटिक इररिड्यूसिबल, इररिड्यूसिबल मीन्स सी फर्स्ट इट इज अ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन and we cannot factorize this x square plus 1, right? This x square plus 1 is a irreducible. We cannot reduce this x square plus 1. So this expression is known as a quadratic irreducible expression. So for quadratic irreducible equation, numerator will be bx plus c. Okay? So these are the three types of partial fractions. First one is denominator is having linear and different factors. So for that we have to write a upon first factor plus b upon second factor. Case 2, when denominator has linear but repeated factors. So for that a upon ax plus b one time plus b upon ax plus b whole square, right? Since it is repeated twice. In third case, one is linear and the other factor is quadratic but irreducible. So partial fraction will be a upon ax plus b plus bx plus c. This is important part. Okay, for quadratic numerator will be bx plus c. Okay, so bx plus c upon x square plus c. Now some example. So for the following fractions, write down the correct partial fractions form, right? So just identify on the basis of factors of denominator, write down whether it is a type 1, type 2 or type 3 type. Okay, so what will be the partial fraction for first one? So for first one, check the denominator, right? Factors of denominator is linear and different. So partial fraction will be a upon x plus 1 plus b upon 3x minus 4, right? Then second example, for second example it is a quadratic equation, right? Right? Degree of polynomial in denominator is 2. So it is a quadratic. So for quadratic, first check whether it is reducible or irreducible. So x square minus 5x plus 6 can be written as x minus 2 and x minus 3. Right? We can factorize the denominator. Right? Now factors are linear and non-repeated. So partial fraction will be a upon x minus 2 plus b upon x minus 3. Okay, then third one, denominator having two factors x square minus 1 and x plus 1, right? So check this x square minus 1 can be reducible, right? We can write this as x plus 1, x minus 1, right? X plus 1, x minus 1. So this will be 3x plus 1 upon x square minus 1 is x plus 1, x minus 1 into x plus 1, right? I am writing this x square minus 1 as x plus 1, x minus 1. Okay? Now, that means that is equal to 3x plus 1 upon x plus 1, x plus 1 repeated twice. So, that will be x minus 1 and x plus 1 whole square. Okay? Now, third case is repeated case, linear but repeated. So, partial fractions will be a upon x minus 1 plus b upon x plus 1 plus c upon x plus 1 whole square. Right? Third one. Now, fourth one. As I told you, denominator is having quadratic equation, but this quadratic equation is irreducible. We cannot factorize this x square plus 1, and hence partial fraction will be a upon x plus 1 plus, for x square plus 1 will be bx plus c upon x square plus 1. Okay, then fifth one, x square plus x plus 1. Again, this is a quadratic equation, and this quadratic equation is irreducible. We cannot reduce this quadratic equation. Therefore, partial fraction will be a upon x minus 1 plus bx plus c upon x square plus x plus 1. Okay? So, with this, I am concluding my video. So, thank you, class. In next lecture, we can see the further part of partial fractions. So, thank you, students.